all this fishing line and other stuff. See how this bearing carrier is out like that? This one is not like that. It has actually been eaten away. If you look here, this prop hub is actually sticking up compared to these right there. See, this one is moving with the lever there, and that one is not. Now, we haven't made one of these videos in a while, Donnie. We're gonna be doing a full service on these three engines. This is probably Donovan's least favorite engine he's ever had to deal with.
What? How dare you? How dare you?
Is that not a true statement?
Disrespect my babies. L6 Verado, that's my favorite motor on the planet.
Yeah, these are probably some of the easiest engines to service ever. What's included in your service is basically spark plugs, oil filters, fuel filters, water pumps, gear lube, engine oil, anodes, water separators, thermostats, and what else? Am I missing anything?
I didn't hear what you just said.
So we're just gonna start with that and take these cowlings off, start changing out a lot of our parts and letting you know what we see and what you should kind of look at when you do a service. First thing what we're gonna look at when we pop these cowlings off are the cowling latches, at least for these engines here when doing a service. So Donnie's gonna pop the two tops, or the three tops off, and then he's gonna flip the lever, I'm gonna pull the backs off, and we're gonna see if we got any broken cowling latches when we do that.
We got broken latches, son.
So you can see these here are the latches for the back cowling, and you can see this one is moving with the lever there, and that one is not. I just got the first propeller off of here, and this is one thing that you want to look for, is all this fishing line and other stuff that's can get caught up behind your propeller. It could cut that seal that's right in there, so you definitely want to make sure you take off all the props. These you got to take the props off anyway, because those are the drain seals for the lower unit. So now that I got all the props off, something that I noticed, which is kind of not good. So you can see how this bearing carrier is out like that. This one is not like that. It has actually been eaten away. Look how deep that is. This is fishing line that has gotten eaten up.
Let me get them oil filters.
And that right there, oil filters, okay.
Thank you very much.
Well, back to this. That got all that fishing line out of there now. Well, you can see how clean this one is and how this one's been ground down quite a bit. I just took out all that fishing line, but if you look here, this prop hub is actually sticking up compared to these right there. See how that one's flush right there? And this one is sticking up about a 16th of an inch or so. So this needs to get a hub put in it, because that has sunk down in there and allowed the prop to eat up a portion of this bearing carrier. Pretty commonly known, but you always want to put some oil on the oil filter gasket, because you never want a dry gasket and you want it to come off next time. I'm gonna go hand tight, or as tight as possible. It's a pretty bad angle here with these filters.
So kind of a hit or miss way to find out how stretched out the belt is and see what kind of life it has left is to look at this little box right here on the tensioner. And there's an arrow, I don't know whether you can see that, that should be pointing somewhere in this box. As you can see, that arrow is way outside of the box, and that belt is very stretched. So I'll show you what it looks like with a new belt.
everything. I'm going to drain them all before I take them off to do the impellers. So you just got to take this 10 mil and that 10 mil off. You don't want to do a flat head because these really stick in there. You really want to put a 10 mil socket on this in order to pull that drain.
All right, got the new belt on there, and you can already see that that arrow is sitting about in the middle of that box. So, yeah, it was, you could tell just by the way it felt taking it off and putting it on, the difference in how stretched that old belt was. So, fun fact.
And the waiter. Snap that new one down in there. Simple as that.
All right, I'm going to take these four nuts off so I can drop these lower units. We gotta pull this thing right here, and there's a half inch bolt holding this anode on. That's got another bolt up in there. So I'm gonna take those off to drop these lowers. We got all the nuts and bolts and everything out of these lower units, just down to the one here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and drain the lower unit oil, check everything. I'm going to drain them all before I take them off to do the impellers. So you just got to take this 10 mil and that 10 mil off. You don't want to do a flat head because these really stick in there. You really wanted to put a 10 mil socket on this in order to pull that drain. When you take these off, you want to make sure you get all of the old O-ring off there, because you can get pieces that'll stick on there. So definitely make sure you get these taken off when you pull the old drain plugs. But seeing how much fishing line was on that prop shaft, no water in the gear case, very good sign. Just some dirty oil, but nothing to be alarmed or concerned about as far as the seals are concerned.
All right, now we're gonna pull the spark plugs. You just wanna unplug all the coils, take them all out, get the spark plugs out, and get them changed.
I'm just trying to figure out a scheduling deal, because I'd like to come down and kind of,
stuff.
Jeez. She heavy.
Ooh. What was that?
Did you get a box?
Here you got your prop hub. It was the hub that broke. Snapped that whole thing off right there. Push her out. Alright, Donnie's cleaning up. We're pretty close to being done with the full service. We got the belts, the plugs, the fuel filters, the oil filters, the water pumps, the gear lube. All that stuff's done. We got to add the oil. The only thing that we're missing is the thermostats and the anodes. So we do need to change up under here. There's an anode. There's these anodes here. And then there's the anodes that go there. So we do need to change those anodes as well as the thermostats and add the oil. But other than that, that's pretty much going to be all of our service. We don't have the anodes on hand. We don't have the thermostats. So we'll have to come back to do those. But